Kia ora and welcome to Football Fern special today, the Algarve Cup in Portugal. A century of games for Gregorius, but a squad packed with players who aren't really playing at the moment. Lining up for TVNZ Football Club today is Victor Waters, former Football Fern Katie Duncan and Simon Plum. Katie, welcome back.
Thanks.
Former Football Fern this time. Last time you were on, you were building up for the World Cup, weren't you?
Yep.
How is it, retirement?
It's been quite nice, actually. Bit of a change, obviously, from the slog off training every day to just kicking back a bit. It's been quite nice.
It must be quite a tough transition, though, isn't it? Because I remember when you came in here last time, it was a World Cup preview. You'd come out of retirement, and that was sort of the driving force before you coming back. And yeah, obviously things have changed now.
Yeah, it is. The transition's always a bit tough, especially when the girls get together like they are on tour, and you're seeing all this, you know, Snapchats and Instagrams and stuff, and you're like, oh. You know, missing my mates and my teammates, but they're having a good time and hopefully do well in the game coming up.
And life has changed for you somewhat since when you were playing as well, a little bubba ganoush now.
Yep, little Nadia, 7 months now. It's probably been a good distraction actually from retirement to baby. You don't really have much time to think about, you know, the what ifs and, oh, I should have maybe kept going, but she's been a good distraction and it's been really fun so far.
Time flies, eh? Because the World Cup doesn't feel like that long ago, but it was, and the Ferns haven't played since then, so it's actually been quite a long time between drinks for them.
It has. We're actually not that far from another World Cup when you think about it, and we've got a hosting bid potentially. It's kind of all haywire, but in terms of the games, it's great to get them back on the field. Belgium, a side that they've never played before in this Algarve Cup, basically a pretty high-quality European tournament with New Zealand chucked in. It'll be a good challenge for them, for sure. Mm.
Very good mix of teams. You've got the Ferns, so playing Belgium tomorrow morning at 7 o'clock. Then, depending on the result there, they've got Italy or Portugal, and then Denmark, Germany, Norway or Sweden. So it's actually really high calibre opposition.
Yeah, and the Algarve Cup is sort of described as this mini World Cup. I mean, for you guys playing in the team, how important is this tournament for you guys?
Oh, it's always great to have, you know, replica-like tournament games. And as you said, the opposition that we are up against or could be up against is a really good level for us to get results from. So I'm really looking forward to how the girls are going to do.
That was one of the things that Tom Samani bemoaned going into the World Cup, the fact that he didn't have the time, he didn't have the games. You've got some games now, but not many of the players are actually playing at the moment because they're coming in off seasons, particularly in America. I think only six of the squad are actually playing regular football at the moment. So how frustrating would that be for them?
Yeah, I mean, that's always the challenge with the Ferns. One-off games we can do quite well at, but it's the tournaments that really matter with the results, and it's the back-to-back games that really count. Little tournaments like this really do matter.
Is that something that makes retiring and unretiring tricky? Because you've sort of got those marquee tournaments to look forward to, but there's not an awful lot internationally that goes on in between. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, the thing is, you just kind of, you've got to go with what comes and take the opportunities that do come up. I thought we had quite a good lead up to the World Cup last year. It ended up being quite a long time away before the World Cup, which you've always got to weigh up, right? Is it a good thing? Is it a bad thing? But we got some good games under our belts, got the result against England. So, I mean, it's always adding up the pros and cons, but I think the more games, the better, obviously. It's always harder for us little Kiwis over the other side of the world, but hoping we'll do good this tournament.
If we cast our mind back to that World Cup, results weren't ideal for the Football Ferns. And because we've had this long break now, what do you think that the goal has to be out of this tournament? Because Tokyo is not going to be too far around the corner after this.
Yeah, I just wonder, you know, these sort of tournaments, I remember the last World Cup, that last game, that we still had some hope of qualifying. But those sort of, this must help to prepare for those sort of pressure games, those pressure situations, surely.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm sure Tom will be wanting to perhaps experiment still with formations and players. You know, there's a few new players on this tour, and so he might want to look at a few different players. And obviously, to get results and to get wins under your belts just creates the confidence in the team. So I'm sure he'll be wanting to get some results too.
You mentioned that you miss the camaraderie with the Snapchats and the Instagrams and all those sorts of things. Are you sticking around the football scene? What are you going to be doing now that you have stepped away from the international scene?
Yeah, you can't kind of step out completely off it, can you, even if you try to? I'm actually coaching, I'm the Girls Academy Director at the New Auckland United Club. So that's great because I can really impact and influence the players. It's under 10 to under 16 for the girls, and I've got my own under 14 team. Who are a decent team. They played versus boys last year, so I'm really glad that they're in the academy and that I'm coaching them. And football-wise, though, I'm not going to look to play this year. I'm just stepping away a bit and focusing on my coaching.
So you've played for quite a few coaches, international coaches as well. If you had to take the best qualities of, say, a Tom Samani and previous Ferns coaches, Andreas Haraf, what will you and what won't you be doing?
Wow, they're complete opposite people, so that is interesting to look at them both. But I guess with Tom, his relaxed personality and laid-back type style, not putting too much pressure on the players is always a good
Samani
thing.
Samani sunglasses as well, definitely.
Definitely. Sudoku puzzles, he does. Yes. Loves them every breakfast, yeah. And obviously, you know, you can't be too hard, especially when you're working with youth players. You know, players are going to make lots of mistakes, well, even senior players, but not to be too hard on them and always keep it fun. You know, that's why we play football, because we enjoy it and we don't get paid millions, not yet, by like some of the men do. So, you know, you've got to keep it fun and keep the girls interested in the game is really important.
Nicely done. I reckon we'll take a wee break now. After this, we'll come back and talk about some of the players retiring from the Ferns and joining the Century Club. Well, Sarah Gregorius is set to bring up 100 games. An illustrious club, that. Only 10 players have done it for the Football Ferns, and you're one of them. So what would be your message to Sarah Gregorius?
Score a goal, will you?
Just somebody score a goal.
No, I'm super stoked for Gregorius. She deserves it, and she's a great girl off the pitch too. And so, you know, this will be great for her to get that 100th cap.
I mean, 100 games at international football, the fact that we've got 10 of them, that's remarkable.
It is remarkable. Whatever sport you play, if you represent your country 100 times, that's some going, particularly in a career that, you know, by early, mid-30s, you could probably be retired by all circumstances, if you avoid injury, if you're lucky. It's a remarkable hit rate, absolutely.
I mean, for yourself, just deviating back to that, on the injury front, do you feel lucky that you've been able to sort of retire on your own terms, or do you feel like the body's been left battered and bruised after the years of playing?
Yeah, I am very glad that I didn't have to retire because of injury or anything. Although, you know, even if I go for the odd run now, my knees are a bit creaky, but, you know, nothing serious, so I am pretty lucky there.
Do you think Sarah can keep playing for a little bit longer? Obviously, we don't want to preempt people's retirements, but there's been some chatter about whether she'd sort of wind it down sooner or whether she can extend out to Tokyo.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Obviously, I'd love to see her at the Olympics too, and I guess we'll just have to wait and see and hope that she scores her, you know, go on her 100th cap.
Yeah.
How does
the
game change after you've brought up your 100 caps?
Yeah.
Does the game sort of change for you a little bit, or was it just the same?
Not at all. It's exactly the same. I guess, yeah, it's great that you have the experience under your belt, 100 games, but nothing changes. Yeah.
Do they do anything special for you? Like the All Blacks get one of those nice silver caps. Does New Zealand football shell out for anything?
Yeah, we do get one of those cool little caps.
Do they?
Oh, brilliant.
Yeah.
Great.
Nice. So they do a little on-field presentation, or is it all done?
It's normally presented after, but normally you do a little cake or something in the evening, a little celebration. maybe some bubbles actually as well. Nice. You know, got to celebrate these milestones.
Absolutely. A cake and cap and bubbles,
Looking back on your career, Katie, is there any particular games that really stand out to you that you always kind of, that you hold dear to your heart?
Certainly the opening game of the London Olympics. Mm. That was actually before the opening ceremony, and it was the first game of the whole Olympics, so quite a milestone, and it was versus Great Britain, and just the atmosphere and turning up on the bus and the streets lined with people, and we narrowly lost that game, but it was that was definitely a highlight to me. Awesome.
Someone else who has recently retired in the last week, in fact, Amber Hearn, scored a lot of goals, over 50 goals, the most out of any New Zealand man or woman. Looking back on her career, how much of an impact do you think she's had on the Football Ferns?
Oh, massively. She's a great goal scorer. I played back with her when I moved up to Auckland, actually, at Lynavon, and she would score bucket loads of goals then as well. But she was an amazing player and great work rate, and would score a lot of goals for us. And she's definitely left some hard boots to fill in the Football Ferns.
Because that's an area where we are struggling at the moment, particularly at the World Cup. I don't know if any Football Fern scored at the last World Cup. It was an own goal, wasn't it?
That's right.
So,
and saying that the under-17s, we scored plenty of goals in that World Cup. So there is a lot of potential and a lot of future is bright for New Zealand football, especially the women's game.
But it just shows that at that level, that strikers, they are worth their weight in gold because they're the ones that that have the hardest job.
100%. And if you go through a group game or two without scoring, it really dumps a load of pressure on you. And then the team starts stretching and panicking a little bit. It's hard work. But like you say, if you have that one player, but now you could possibly say that there's a real gap there for a new player to come through from the younger ranks.
Does it feel strange now, the fact that you've had, this will be the first squad named post-retirement, right, for you? So now you're going to start seeing faces, some of the younger crew coming through. Do you feel like, I'm not kind of, it's hard to keep up with the new generation?
A little bit, to be fair. Yeah. I need to keep better tabs on what's happening, really. But, it's a good for these young ones coming through, and hopefully they do get a bit of game time this tour as well.
Nice to see an elite back in the squad, the goalkeeper, young goalkeeper, didn't play at the last World Cup, made herself unavailable for the squad. I think she wanted to sort of focus on uni and that sort of thing. But if she gets some game time here, she'd make her senior debut. I don't know if that's going to be an option, but again, very exciting young talent that could be coming through
absolutely.
Now.
Absolutely. I remember that penalty at the World Cup, at the under-17s World Cup. What a special, special talent she is. Mm. Great shot stopper as well.
And goal scorer. Obviously.
And goal scorer, obviously. But just obviously the leadership and the mentality to go, you know what, penalty shootout, World Cup's on the line, but I'm going to go up as a goalkeeper and score a goal.
That's a boss move.
Absolutely.
Very boss move. Let's wrap up with World Cup bid 2023, Australia, New Zealand. Mm. You must just be thinking, can I unretire again?
That's a bit far on from me, but I hope, obviously I'd love for that to happen and I'd want to be involved some way or another. So, fingers crossed that we can get the bid.
I mean, look, let's be honest. With FIFA bids, you just do not know what is going to happen, how it's going to pan out. Yeah. But it would be massive.
It would, obviously, it'd be a co-host with Australia. We're kind of supporting their hosting. But to have that quality of player in our backyard playing would be phenomenal. We've seen it before with Youth World Cups, the difference it makes. Mm-hmm. And make no mistake, the Women's Football World Cup is a huge event.
Yeah.
For the Ferns now and for yourself, when you started your career, the Olympics, would that have been bigger than the World Cup, or is the World Cup still the biggest? Because with the men's side of thing, it's an easy contest, it's the World Cup. But for the women's, the World Cups have had to sort of build over the last few tournaments.
Yeah, they've always been a little, probably Olympics tipping World Cup. It's more equal, I guess, now. It's a different feel, though. With the Olympics, you're a part of the Olympic team, the New Zealand team. Yeah. Mm. So it's like you've got a bigger team, which is quite a cool feeling, too. You know, like support, whereas the World Cup, you're just your team, you've got you and you're focusing, so it is a different feel, but both, amazing, obviously.
Well, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Good luck for your retirement, and we'll see you for your unretirement 2023 World Cup. That is going to be us for this week. If you don't already, why not subscribe to the podcast? Just search TVNZ Football Club in all the usual places, and you can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, or check us out on the One News website. We'll see you next time.